dedicated to providing a quality education which focuses on integrating the Ojibwe culture into all students' learning experiences. Every learner will have the opportunity to be challenged, to succeed, and to be prepared for the future. Parents, staff, community members, and students will demonstrate the highest level of expectations for themselves and for the school.
Aaniin get your dog. Minogi gi jabe. Abawa noon goom. It's nice out today. And comparatively to what the weather that we have had, it is nice out today. Still cool. But I'll go with our above freezing weather. Say, I just have a few announcements to make today. We just had mid-quarters on Friday, so you'll be receiving your mid-quarter grades soon. Please take a look at them, a peek at them. Think about if you're satisfied with your performance. If not, make changes. It's up to you. You are the one who has to sit down and actually do the work, and that's just the way it is. That's life. You have to do your own work in order to succeed and get what you want. So take a look at those grades and see if you're happy with them. And if you're not, keep working at it and ask for help. And what also will help you with that is attendance. If you show up for class, wow, it makes a big difference in just getting, increasing your knowledge and in growing that brain of yours. I do want to give a shout out to our second graders. 2 weeks ago, they had perfect attendance for the entire week. Pretty amazing, second graders, and way to go, families. Very nice job. And then also on Friday, we had a K3 fun dance party. It was pretty fun. I had a good time. Thanks for dancing with me. I appreciate it. And thanks to Josh and John for helping to host the event. So, Achieve 3000, guess what? We have a fourth grade student who on February 18th received the highest daily score in the whole state of Minnesota. So for all the Minnesota schools who are using Achieve 3000, he did it. Highest score for the day. Pretty amazing. Way to go. And then I was also looking at our scores, and did you know, sixth graders, that the fifth graders have a higher percentage of activities completed at 75% or higher? So my challenge, sixth graders, is you need to get the higher percentage next time. So work at it. Work at it, and I'll take a peek at those scores. So I hope everyone has a good week. Stay safe. Be kind. All right. Miigwech, bizindawi yeg. Right now, I just...
That's exactly what you say. You gotta put your past behind you. Look, kid, bad things happen, and you can't do anything about it, right?
Right.
Wrong! When the world turns its back on you, you turn your back on the world.
So it was stuck down here. We might as well be on another planet.
Wally!
I can't believe you. There is no way.
Who's your friend who likes to play?
His rocket makes you yell hooray.
You must not let anyone define your limits because of where you come from. Your only limit is your soul.
All it takes is faith and trust.
Ohana means family. Family means nobody
gets left behind
or forgotten.
today is history. Tomorrow is a mystery, but today is a gift. That is why it is called the present.
Hello, everybody. It's Officer Chad. So I was asked to read a book for you guys for Learn to Read Month. And this is the book I'm going to read. It's called The Story of Rock. Rock and roll, some of my favorite things, is one of my favorite things on earth. Love music and I love rock and roll. I bet Mr. Josh will like this book too. So I'm going to read it to you. Let's go. There's an old song that says blues has music in its soul. Then the blues had a baby and they named it rock and roll. Chuck Berry came along with his guitar and made it sing. That's Chuck Berry right there. Then Elvis Presley shook things up and the people crowned him king. There's Elvis Presley, the king of rock and roll. Bob Dylan gave us poetry. The Rolling Stones brought style. And there they are, Bob Dylan and the Rolling Stones. And then with Beatlemania, rock made the world go wild. Everybody loved the Beatles. In the long summer of love, Janis Joplin's voice rang loud. There's Janis Joplin. The Who smashed their instruments, and the Dead jammed for the crowd. There's the Who. They like to smash up their instruments at their concerts. That's kind of crazy. And these guys down here were called the Grateful Dead. That's the name of their band. In 69 at Woodstock, hippies gathered all around. That was Woodstock. I bet you Miss Sharon might have been there. Ha ha. Hendrix wailed on his guitar, and it was such an awesome sound. There's Jimi Hendrix. Aerosmith dreamed on while Zeppelin played full blast. There's Aerosmith and Zeppelin. The Ramones played punk rock really, really fast. That's the Ramones. They're punk rockers. AC/DC wore school uniforms while playing Back in Black. AC/DC is one of my favorites right there. That's Angus Young playing his guitar in his school uniform. Scaramouche, sang Queen as they brought the opera back. There's Freddie Mercury from Queen, another one of my favorites. David Bowie sang Let's Dance. Oh, the man, he knew how to dress. There's David Bowie. He dressed up as a bunch of different things. Tina Turner ruled the 80s. Her voice was simply the best. There's Tina. 80s rock had big screens and even bigger hair. Slash couldn't see his guitar, and Bon Jovi was living on a prayer. Guns N' Roses, one of the greatest bands out there. John Bon Jovi. Pearl Jam and Nirvana rocked with the lights out. There's Pearl Jam and Nirvana. In Seattle, grunge was born. Then ska fused with rock, and you had no doubt. And there's no doubt. Weezer dressed like Buddy Holly, and their cruises were a ball. And who knew the White Stripes weren't brother and sister after all? There's Weezer. And there's the White Stripes. Now some people say that rock is dead. Most greats are in the sky. But the real truth is that rock and roll will never die. There's kids listening to rock and roll. And as long as people keep listening, rock and roll will be there forever. Thanks for letting me read you guys a book. Always remember, reading is great. It's one of my favorite things. See you later. Have a great day.
Hey guys, Mr. B again. Just letting you know that this week's sponsor letter of the week is the letter L. L is for a healthy lunch that gives you fuel to grow. Thank you, letter L.
Hey kids, I bought my daughter a locket and I put her picture in it. Now she's independent.
Nagana Zidmanidu, Dapanigo, Awa Sema, Miigwech, Nibith, Asanig, Ishkode, Mitchagoog, Wabanong, Zawanong, Ngubinong, Giwidimnong, Oma Aking, Ishpamim, Miigwech.
Sugar and spice.